Wow!
Look at this thing!
Absolutely mangled!
Let's do another one. Wait, why am I doing this?
Aside from it being totally intoxicating.
Well, because these old server drives behind me are loaded with data that is so sensitive that I am legally obligated to destroy them. Since we're at it anyway, I thought I'd show you guys the AtRack mobile data destruction system here, complete with degaussing magnet and hydraulic press. When this thing's done with your drive, you will not be getting anything off of it. But Linus, you might say, what about an SSD? Oh, that's gotta hurt. Turns out it can do those too. But Linus, you might say, think of the turtles or your staff.
I need hard drives.
Couldn't I just erase them and sell them? Maybe at a nice discount? The answer is yes, but also more complicated than you might expect. There are a lot of ways to erase data, and they're not all created equal. Kind of like my segues. To our sponsor.
XSplit. Level up your live streams with simple yet effective broadcasting and video production tools for use on platforms like Twitch and YouTube. Check out XSplit at the link below and use code Linus for 69% off your first purchase or subscription. Nice.
A quick search of eBay will reveal tons of listings for used magnetic hard drives. So clearly, plenty of folks out there are taking the wipe and resell approach. But as you probably already know, just hitting delete and emptying the recycle bin is not a secure method of erasing data. And even a format doesn't necessarily make everything on a storage device unrecoverable. Just check out the results of using test disk on an SD card full of deleted text files if you don't believe me. So, to prepare a drive for sale, you need to do things right. Pun intended, because the simplest method of doing that is to write zeros over the entire disk. Then you want to go back and read it to ensure that there's nothing but zeros to be found. It's quite effective at preventing someone with a simple piece of free software from recovering all of your Nana's recipes, but what if you're a bank, or hospital, or the CIA? Well, the answer there is, it depends. In the past, ne'er-do-wells could conceivably use a technique called magnetic force microscopy to pull data off of a drive that had already been overwritten. The idea behind it was that not every write operation on a particular bit of storage would be lined up with exact precision on the disk. We're gonna have a couple of papers in the description linked down below. It's super interesting stuff. And this potential attack vector led to a series of data deletion standards that would call for between 3 and 36 passes writing over the drive, alternately filling it with zeros, then ones, then random characters, or even predefined patterns. With modern hard drives, like these ones, however, the components and the tolerances have shrunk so much that the possibility of fragments being left behind that could be read is basically zero. So new standards, like NIST 888, have come along, which now say that for storage devices containing magnetic media, a single overwrite pass with a fixed pattern, such as binary zeros, typically hinders recovery of data, even if state-of-the-art laboratory equipment is used to attempt it. So you're probably thinking, if anyone with a computer could do that at home, why is this machine still necessary? Well, the issue is doing it at scale. You see, with great capacity comes great write times. So even drives that have built-in ATA secure erase commands, which should be anything made after about 2001, can take hours or even an overnight operation to fully clear. And if you're that hypothetical bank or three-letter agency, you could have hundreds or even thousands of drives to sanitize and dispose of. Ain't nobody got time for that. I mean, even if you were willing to pay some junior IT tech to wipe drives all day every day, buddy better have the appropriate clearance to handle it. And even if they do, something is eventually going to slip through the cracks. Like that one time when my former employer didn't wipe their employee records. Yeah, Yeah, good times. I mean, that was bad enough, but hey, look, imagine if the data slipping through the cracks was, I don't know, a list of your nation's covert intelligence sources in North Korea or something. That is where the mobile data destruction system comes in. It's fast enough to process Mount Hard Drive here, that's another fun dad joke, in about an hour. And the first stage is the degausser. And this bad boy is no joke. We all know that hard drive storage is magnetic, but what a lot of people don't realize is that this is perfectly safe. You would need a much stronger magnet than anything you'd find on a screwdriver to do anything to a modern drive. And there are a lot of different ways to skin this cat, but this particular unit builds up an electrical charge in its capacitors, then discharges the energy as one big high-frequency electromagnetic pulse. So long as that pulse is stronger than the hard drive's coercivity, that is, its resistance to magnetic change, the pulse will randomize the polarity of all the little magnetic bits, wiping out the data permanently. And this is really important, the drive doesn't need to be functional for the degausser to be effective. You guys ready? This bad boy puts out a field of about 10,000 Gauss, which is about double the coercivity of both conventional and shingled hard drives. Ooh, there it goes. Meaning that aside from the data itself being gone, all the tracks on the platters will be destroyed. And anecdotally, we've heard that it can even shift around internal components or demagnetize the permanent magnets in the drive. It's kind of the nuke it from orbit option. It still looks perfectly normal, but this drive is now completely unusable, which raises a question. Why do we need the rest of this getup here? Well, modern privacy and data protection laws require a more systematic approach, and the MDDS is more than just a degausser and a crusher on a cart. Let me show you guys the workflow. We start by scanning in the serial number of our drive, then placing it here to take a before picture. AtRack is working on an AI module that will just read the serial number from the picture, but that's not ready yet. Then it pops into the degausser. We've already hit this drive once, but doing it again isn't gonna hurt it any more than it already is. Run. Right now, it's charging up its capacitors, then it's gonna take all that power and, I don't know if you'd call that an electromagnetic pop or thunk. Has anyone around here got a pacemaker? No? Oh good. Probably should have checked that before we started, but everyone's still standing. I think we're all right. AtRack says that we should only measure about 5 of this unit's 10,000 Gauss directly above the unit where the shielding is weakest. That could potentially impact older pacemakers, but that's within the occupational safety limits for short exposures, so it should be fine. After the thud, we wait for the Raspberry Pi controller to pop up. Once this readout says success, the data is gone. But this next step is still important for a few reasons. One, it gives us an obvious visual indicator that this thing ain't gonna work no more. Two, the more extreme data protection standards do still call for physical destruction. And number three, and this is the most important, it's super fun to watch. Oh, you doing okay, buddy? It didn't go. It's in there right the right way. I don't wanna not follow the instructions. Did I put it upside down or something? Destruction fail, open door. Oh, this is a helium drive. This is a sealed drive.
We spoke with AtRack about the difficulty that we had crushing these beefier unibody hard drives. And it turns out the crusher in our cart was modified to run on 110 volt power. And as a result, doesn't have quite the same oomph of the production units. AtRack picked up a few of these drives to double check, and their production unit made short work of them.
Once a drive is crushed, we shake any loose bits out into the drawer down here, throw it back under the camera for an after picture, and all of that gets logged to AtRack's redundant cloud servers, and then you can print off a certificate of destruction for your local records. Kinda wonder what else we could crush in this thing. That would make a great Floatplane exclusive. Maybe, yeah, we'll have the social team do that. lmg.gg/floatplane, coming soon. That aside, I can practically hear you guys saying, Linus, what about SSDs? Don't worry, we're gonna get to that. But first, we need to at least mention new magnetic hard drive technologies like heat-assisted magnetic recording, or HAMR. In a nutshell, these cutting-edge drives achieve much greater storage density by using platter materials with much higher coercivity. As you can imagine from when we were talking about the degausser, this helps to prevent accidental flips to nearby bits when they're exposed to the right head. But it presents some other challenges, like, well, how do you intentionally write to the bit you're actually targeting? It's super cool. In less than a nanosecond, they heat the target bit up with a laser to around 450 degrees Celsius, which reduces the coercivity. Then they write it and rapidly cool it back down to lock in the data. At this time, we're not aware of a degausser that is capable of clearing a hammer drive yet, but we're told that they are in the works. So for now, a drive shredder might be your best bet for hammer. Rack told us they're working on a shredder attachment for this unit, and if you guys are into this stuff, I would love to get our hands on it and show it to you. Now let's finally talk about SSDs and all your other non-magnetic storage. The degausser isn't gonna do jack squat to these either, and overwriting them might not be totally secure either if the drive uses automatic wear leveling, which pretty much any modern consumer SSD would. As with hammer drives then, that leaves you with secure erase, which at least is refreshingly quick on an SSD, and if properly implemented, should be good enough for anyone to resell the drive without worrying about recovery. But in cases where you have to be 100% sure that nothing's getting through the cracks, our crusher has a cool little accessory that not only crushes the drives, but also ensures damage to each and every memory chip on the board. That's scary looking. Let's give it a try. All we gotta do is pull out the hard drive attachments. Okay. Put this bad boy in here. Yeah, a little something like that. Seems legit. You wanna see a 2.5 inch or an M.2?
Yes.
All right. Well, let's start with one of the, what the heck, it could probably do both. Here we go. Sayonara, buddy. Oh. Oh, there we go. Did we get all the chips? Let's see. Oh, wow. I mean, the whole board came in half. That's probably a good sign. NAND chip, dead. NAND chip, in half. Other more different NAND chip, that's not quite half, but that's definitely some fraction. The controller survived, but there's no data on there. Last NAND chip, definitely dead. Now how about this boy? Oh, okay, well, there's one NAND chip. I think it's dead. Obviously, we are talking thousands of dollars in the hardware alone, not to mention the software and integration work around this whole process and the redundant servers around the world keeping your logs safe for years to come. But the way that AtRack envisions things, these carts are gonna just live in the data center. They're safe to use in either the hot or cold aisle, and with an all-inclusive leasing cost of less than $1,000 a month, they should quickly pay for themselves in time saved. I personally would love to see them have an attachment, maybe, I don't know, down here or something, where you can load in drives for secure erasing that maybe could then be tested and sold if they still work. I mean, if it's bad, obviously just crush those ones. But I can also understand that regulations is regulations, at least until we can change them, and I do get it, even if I don't like it. Oh. There's one more thing we should touch on. Let's talk about SEDs, or self-encrypting drives. These have a data encryption key that's set at the factory, and they automatically encrypt or decrypt data that is being written to or read from the drive. The whole thing is transparent to the user, apart from entering their password at boot. The cool trick with these is that without the key, the data on the drive is essentially just random characters. So all you need to do to erase that drive permanently is to overwrite the data encryption key. This is called a cryptographic erase and is effectively instantaneous, making it perhaps the most time-effective method of data destruction while still allowing reuse of the drive. Many SSDs have self-encryption features like these already, but don't enable them by default. So you can check the security settings in your PC BIOS or do a little bit of Googling to figure out how to get started on your platform. Software-based encryption works similarly and is also possible, but usually comes with some kind of performance hit, so we'll have a couple guides linked down below. It's important to remember in all of this that the schemes we're talking about, though, are for protecting the data at rest on the drive, or once it's dead. This is not magically protecting that picture of your lunch that you're uploading to the gram. And while self-encrypting disks and full disk encryption might be the best way forward, there's still going to be a place for setups like this for a long time, because reliable, trackable data destruction is critical for many industries. And sponsors are critical for reliable segue to
Squarespace. Creating your own website doesn't have to be difficult. Luckily, with Squarespace, it isn't. Their all-in-one platform makes it easy to get your website up and running quickly. Designing with their Fluid Engine site builder is a breeze. Start with a template and customize every detail imaginable with drag-and-drop technology for desktop or mobile. You can also use their asset library to manage all your files from one central hub and use them across the Squarespace platform. With Squarespace's analytic insights, you can see what's working well and what needs a little TLC. And if you need help, Squarespace has got your back with helpful guides and a 24/7 support team. Head to squarespace.com/LTT and get 10% off today.
If you guys liked this video, maybe check out the one from a few years back about the Red Key data destruction tool. It's still available for purchase, even if they don't have the cool key-shaped USB drive anymore.